Hi, Kat.
Hey, John.
How are you?
I'm good, John. How are you?
I am doing well, thank you.
Great. I'm so glad to hear that.
Yeah. Well, you should be.
Wow.
Let's face it. I'm just in purely practical terms. Uh-huh. It's like, if I tell you I'm doing real bad, Kat, you're like, oh, great, I got to carry this motherfucker
That's fair.
For an hour.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I got some pep in my step. I'm good to go for a Monday. It's amazing.
And I am glad then. I am glad to hear that.
Yeah. Good. Good. Woohoo! What, Kat, what?
John.
What are we doing?
Dude, we're recording a podcast.
Okay. I thought that was the answer, but it's always good to confirm, verify. So podcast. So what kind of podcast?
All I can think of is Patty Lynn now.
Yeah.
How much she hates this part of the podcast.
80% of the time.
we on this podcast, we talk about, did you ask me what we're doing here? Is that what you said?
I said, what kind of podcast?
Oh.
I like to... You know, we have these very, like, microscopic slices of difference in our patter that only you and I enjoy. We've established.
100%.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, John, let me tell you all about it. We record this podcast every week, just about every week. And it's called My Mistake. We talk about mistakes. Yours, mine, other people's. Sometimes we go into history to talk about other people's mistakes. We call those hysterical mistorks.
We call them that every time.
Every time. And sometimes we have guests, as I think I mentioned. Sometimes it's just you and I.
Mm.
And it's just you and I tonight. There's no third voice you're going to hear pop in.
Right. Unless something very unexpected happens.
I mean, we could get Zoom bombed.
We could. Or one of our wives could bust into the room. And
that is a possibility.
It's unlikely, but possible.
So it's just you and I.
Yep.
We have some content tonight. We have.
Yeah.
I wouldn't call this a shit shooter.
This is the it's not a Dunny Dipper. It's not a shit shooter. It's a we got some stuff.
Yeah. We got some stuff.
It's a WGSS.
just rolls off the tongue.
And so doesn't it? It does. Just it's not clunky at all.
No. It's
we got stuff.
We got some stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So here comes the stuff.
Here comes the stuff.
Here comes the stuff.
Here comes the stuff. Here comes the stuff. Well, I have an oops file.
Whoa.
Right? It's been a minute.
Shit. Let me just settle in.
Yeah. Well, settle in. And I'm going to tell you, like, we're going dark early
for
this oops file, just so you know.
Oh, really? Like dark, dark?
I mean, pretty dark, but also... I find it hilarious.
Okay. I mean, we do laugh at pretty horrible things. So
we do. We've been known to. It's I honestly, and what's funny is when I've listened to us when we really let loose on something horrible.
Yeah.
Even though in the moment I'm kind of cringy, like, oh, I shouldn't be doing this. It's always the funniest when we're like laughing at something that really should not be laughed at.
Sure. Yeah.
I get the biggest tickle out of that.
And that's a good sign.
On that note.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Oops Files presents. Man crushed to death stealing catalytic converter in Oakland.
Oh no!
Well, I know, Kat. I know. I'm gonna read the article here.
Oh boy.
Uh huh. Oakland, California. A Vacaville man was killed while allegedly stealing a catalytic converter in Oakland, according to police and media reports. The coroner on Wednesday identified the man as 35-year-old, name omitted by me.
Sure, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. Oakland police said that on March 10th, about 3 a.m., he was found underneath a car committing a crime at the time of their death.
Whoa.
In the 400 block of Lagunitas Avenue near Lake Merritt.
Okay.
The East Bay Times reports he was trying to steal a catalytic converter from a parked Prius nearby.
Oh, it's right? A goddamn Prius.
Of course it is. To newer listeners, and you know, we pick up tens more listeners with every episode.
Oh, absolutely.
You should be aware that I don't laugh lightly, but someone stole the catalytic converter out of my Prius, and it cost me about $3,000 to fix it on a 15-year-old car because it's impossible to buy a new car right now for less than $50,000. So, so I'm not a fan of the people who are be stealing the catalytic converters.
Well, it's a big problem with Priuses. My sister-in-law, her Prius, the catalytic converter was stolen out of her Prius, and apparently she's up in the Bay Area. It's a big problem, and her car has been sitting waiting for a replacement for about a month because it's such a problem up north, especially. So this is like kind of a thing that's really a problem right now, and Prius owners everywhere are just watching their backs because it's not a cheap, as you demonstrated.
Right,
it's not a cheap thing to repair.
No. Now, here's the thing. I own that I was a complete idiot, Kat. Someone attempted to steal catalytic converter, and my wife, who's amazing, like ran out and screamed at them, and they ran away.
She's very brave.
Yeah. But then about 3 months later, after I did not put the protective shield, the armor, under the car, somebody got it. And then I had to pay to have it replaced and pay for the shield to put under the car. Kat, I understand you were planning to put that armor under the car. How'd you do on that?
My Prius is armored.
Hell yeah.
You're
a hard target now.
Bring it.
Yep.
Not really. Don't bring it, please. Leave my Prius alone.
Right. So the East Bay Times reported he was trying to steal a catalytic converter from a parked Prius nearby. Mm. Authorities told the news organization that it seems like I have a problem with this.
Oh.
Kat, do you know what you use to prop up a car so that you can get under it and do stuff?
Yeah, it's those jack things, right?
Right. Like it's a jack.
Yeah.
Yeah. On the other hand, what's the word that you use for when somebody comes up to your car and uses a gun to make you drive them to where they want to go?
John, you'd be getting carjacked.
That's correct. And I want you to know I read this the account of this story from several different publications.
Okay.
All of them said it seems like the carjack that the person was using malfunctioned. And when you read it, it's like, oh, was he trying to jack a car?
Right.
He was trying to jack it up. So anyway, it seemed like the carjack he was using malfunctioned, causing the Prius to slip and crush him.
Oh, God.
A backpack containing cutting tools was found near him, authorities said. Mm-hmm. The converter was still intact. I shouldn't be enjoying this. I really shouldn't.
Oh, God.
But
I mean, a man is dead, John.
I know. And the thing is, every human life is important. And I'm that my philosophy is that way.
Yeah.
And here's the thing. We live in a capitalist society where people feel that they have no way of getting by or living up to the standard that is set by our media other than, you know, being a thief.
Sure. That's true. It happens.
It is possible that this person had no other opportunities in their lives. It's unlikely, I think, being that... this was a healthy white male, but what are you going to do?
We don't know. There's no way to know.
I don't know. In any case, it's an oops. We can all agree it's an oops.
It's definitely an oops.
And it is not the way that I would think anybody would want to be known for having gone out, right?
No. Nope.
So that now it says a growing number of people have been crushed to death while trying to steal catalytic converters.
Oh my God.
In the past few years.
Oh God.
One death happened in Berkeley in March of 2020. Huh. Another in Anaheim in March of 2021.
Okay.
Another occurred in Palmdale last month, and a third occurred this month in Savannah, Georgia.
Wow.
We went far afield there. It was like
it's mostly
Berkeley,
California.
Anaheim, California, Palmdale, California, Savannah, Georgia. But
yeah, very similar to towns, Palmdale and Savannah.
Mm, yeah, very totally.
Similar vibe.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So I see. I would say like Savannah is like Carmel by the Sea. Like that would be kind of a yeah, kind of the actual.
Or like Palmdale, yeah.
Or Palmdale, either one, really. Mm-hmm. You know,
interchangeable.
Take it or lump it. But yeah, so that is the story. I want this story to get out. I want people to know maybe I shouldn't try to make the, you know, whatever $200 that I can make from a stolen catalytic converter because maybe I'll be dead instead.
I think that is absolutely right, John. That is a lesson here. Mm-hmm. Don't do it.
Catalytic converter thievery. Don't do it. Sorry, that's a callback to Heathers and not a good one. Teenage suicide, don't do it. That was topping the charts in Heathers.
I mean, right,
no,
right on.
No, no, okay.
It's been a while since I've seen that movie. I'm sorry.
I know. I understand. We're of different ages. Mm-hmm. And also, I'm a little more goth than you, I think.
That's
and
true. Heathers you're definitely is more goth.
Sort of a gothy movie. So,
yeah. I was like kind of fake goth.
I think everybody who's honest with themselves thinks that when they were goth, they were fake goth.
Oh, I see. Oh, really?
Like I was a poser kind of thing. Although, I mean, I don't know. I wore all black for like 10 years.
Sure.
I used to paint my fingernails black. That's pretty good. I never dyed my hair. I never did that full like, okay. I did bleach it white one time. Now I don't have to bleach it anymore.
Saves a lot of money, John.
It does. A lot of money on toner. That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. 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 So yeah, that's the oops file
for this week. Well, again, I don't think any of our listeners would ever do anything like this. But maybe tell your friends, hey guys, don't steal catalytic converters.
Tell your dirtbag friends.
Tell your dirtbag, call your friends in Palmdale. Uh-huh.
And Savannah, Georgia.
And say, hey, maybe don't do it because you could die a horrible death and then you'll end up as a topic on this podcast, which I feel like is worse than death.
Being the topic on this podcast when you are not a guest on this podcast, not a good thing.
Never
being the topic when you are the guest, we make careers here. We're kingmakers. It's just, you know.
Well, yeah, yes.
That's Kat.
Yeah.
Right.
I didn't.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So there you have it.
There you have it.
Thank you, John. Well done. Thank you for that.
Thank you. You're welcome. It's good.
So listen, we have an email that we can read. Should we go ahead and do that? Or is there something else you wanted to discuss? Or should we just move on?
I feel like it would be really weird if we didn't do it now that you brought it up, Kat.
Okay. Well, I guess we're reading this email.
Make it happen.
Okay. I'm going to make it so.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this email is from @MasterChiefJen.
Master Chief Jen.
Master Chief.
And the subject of this email is the headphone debate. Oh, boy. This is going to get heated again. I feel
It could. She's a bit of a fire stoker.
Is she? Yeah, and I think she's picking up. It's funny. Last week's episode, you and I kind of got into it over our matching headphones that don't exactly match.
Yeah.
And I got a text.
You're under the delusion that yours do something, but they don't. That's all I'm saying.
Am I under delusion, or am I living in a reality where things work the way they're supposed to work?
I've had three sets of these headphones. Yeah. None of them did what you claim that they do.
To tell you. So that's a good example of what conversation we were having last week. And listener Amber shot me a text. She's like, hey, are you and John okay? I was like, oh, is it the headphone thing?
We're
like,
breaking
it's
up.
Fine. That's don't worry about it.
Mom, Dad, are you getting divorced?
Are you guys fighting?
Am I going to have two Christmases?
No. Everything's fine.
Okay, good.
We're staying together for the kids.
That's right. Just until they're grown.
What, another, how many years have we been doing this? I don't know. 14 years?
Easy. Yeah, easily.
Oh, God. Okay, subject is headphone debate.
Mm-hmm.
And Jen starts off this email in a pretty great way. Mm-hmm. She says, hi, Kat. Hi, John. Hi, Anne. Hi, Jen.
Hi, Jen.
How are you all? I'm fine. Moving on. I'm sorry I haven't emailed you in a bit. I've been busy with a new project that I will leave up to you if you want to mention.
We want to mention.
We do, and I'm about to, because it's a new podcast. Woo-hoo! Yay!
Because there aren't enough podcasts.
This is exciting. John, shut up. This is exciting.
Okay, sorry. Yep.
Jen continues, my wife, our friend Stacy, and myself are the hosts, and we actually have an AI producer. It's called How Many Light Bulbs Does It Take? And the first episode will have been released April 1st, so you should go listen, and maybe you guys can be guests on our podcast sometime. Thanks for the plug. If you read this, Jen, come on. Can you imagine Jen, we don't talk about other podcasts.
Right. No, there's just one we don't talk about.
No, there's just one.
And that's the She Nerds Out podcast. We never talk about that.
We do not talk about
it. We don't. It's the podcast that dare not speak its name. But I want to just cut in for a second, Kat.
Please, cut away, my friend.
I listened to episode one of How Many Light Bulbs Does It Take on April 1st, okay?
Because, well, okay, and let me interrupt you. Let me cut in with you, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't know that I hadn't been on Twitter for a little bit, so I apologize. I didn't know that this had been a thing that was announced. Mm. I'm only now seeing it in this email. So, Jen, you're damn right. I'm going to go over and listen to it. Congratulations. Yeah. John, please continue.
Everybody should. No, that's all I'm saying. I listened to it. I feel like it's I like all of the three personalities involved.
Yay.
And the fourth, if you want to include Pod Prod GPT.
Very cool.
Yeah, the cool voice on the AI.
That's so interesting. I'm so intrigued.
It's a very cool premise. Apparently, and I'm very jealous that we didn't think of this first.
Because
apparently their AI has already planned their content for the next 2 years.
Holy shit.
I'm very excited because I know what our next episode is, and that's unusual.
We might have to steal this idea.
Right? I don't know what you're talking about. We've had an AI forever.
Yeah, and we have our next 2 years worth of shows completely planned out.
Totally booked. We got some big names coming up, too.
People who
aren't quite famous yet, but will be soon.
Yeah, they're going to be huge. I'm really intrigued by this. I can't wait to listen to it. I'm trying to imagine what based on, the description and what you're telling me, I'm very intrigued by this. This sounds like a really cool idea.
For sure.
All right, great. So everybody go over and listen to How Many Light Bulbs Does It Take?
Mm-hmm.
And
and the website is hmlditpodcast.com.
Okay.
And that HMLDIT occurs in several places. That's where you find it on Apple Podcasts. I think it's also where it is on Spotify.
Great.
So yeah, check it out.
That's fantastic.
Yep.
Go do that after you listen to this podcast.
Yeah, please do not just pause this and then do that.
No, I mean, it's better if you listen all the way through.
I think so.
thanks for the plug. If you read this and if you didn't read it on air, you can pick up here. That's so nice. Jen's giving us instructions on the copy.
Point.
I love it.
Yep.
Thank you, Jen. You're very sweet. As a previous guest who has waded through the opening banter, I gotta say, I enjoy it. It's funny. That's very kind. It sets the tone, and I don't feel insecure or impatient at all. John, sorry to break that to you.
That is not something bad to break to me. I like it. It just means that there are three of us who enjoy it now.
Right, exactly. But then again, I have served in the military for over 25 years. At this point, I feel I can outweigh a statue. If I'm invited back on again, oh, Jen, you may feel free to do your best to try my patience. Challenge throwdown. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. Yeah,
I want to say if I cause Jen to lose her patience, I win the headband. That's all I'm saying. I win the sushi eating headband.
Oh, interesting.
For which she paid so dearly.
So dearly.
So dearly.
Mm-hmm. Jen continues, as far as the great headphone debate, I feel in this one instance, neither one of you quite know what you're doing. I mean, you're not wrong. You both admitted problems with a new piece of gear the other partner introduced you, just saying. But my bad luck with technology is legendary, so I feel both of you. Good luck with the headphones and that mixer. And happy anniversary, John and Michelle.
Oh, thank you, Jen.
Take care. That's wonderful. And FMP, Jen. Jen, thank you so much. You're very kind.
Master Chief.
And yes, thank you for trying to kind of be the mediator between John and my rift.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, that's a it's such a nice shout out. Happy anniversary to John and Michelle, and you know the beautiful couple.
Oh yes, the beautiful couple. Yes. Like half of that is true, and it ain't on me. But yeah, 16 years, 21 years together.
Amazing.
Yeah. It is a milestone. What are you going to do?
Good. Sweet 16. Pretty good run.
I like it.
Fingers
like
crossed.
It. Yeah, I got a lot of. Let's
keep it going.
Our best years are ahead of us.
I think that's true.
That's what I'm saying.
I think that's true.
Yep. So yeah, we did both have issues with the. The difference is that I also experienced the buzzing issue with the mixer that I sent you.
Yeah.
But I found a technical workaround, and when I tried to describe that technical workaround to you, you were not interested. Because you had already unplugged it and put it in a drawer somewhere.
I think it's right over here, actually.
Yeah.
All right, well, I'll tell you what. You're going to come over. We're going to record in the backyard.
Okay.
But we're going to first, before we record, we're going to have a little tech talk. And you're going to try my headphones that work. And you're going to try to, troubleshoot that mixer that doesn't work. And it's going to be great. Mm-hmm. Everyone's going to win.
Going to be awesome how the mixer's going to just so win. Uh-huh. And you're going to be like, oh, you mean you can hear that? I didn't know that, John.
Mm-hmm.
You're so smart and good looking.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I mean, you know, I'm just... We'll spitballing here what it's going to be.
Well, I mean, we'll see how it goes.
Sure.
I'll leave that open. Like, you know, I don't like to be, I like to be able to, improv a bit. So.
Sure.
Yeah. I like to get locked in.
Yeah. Any way you want to admit you're wrong is fine, Kat. I'm on board for any level of creativity within that.
I mean, again, we'll see. There may not be any admitting to being wrong. So let's just see it. Let's just see what happens.
Sure. If you need me to be the bigger person and pretend like you weren't wrong, I mean, can
you're
do
definitely
that.
The bigger person.
Because
you're taller than me.
Fat jokes now.
No,
fat
you're jokes. Taller than me. How dare you, John? I would never. You know
I'm
that.
One of the few people taller than you.
That's true. It's you, my brother. That's it.
Yep. Everybody else is short.
Everyone else in the world is shorter than me.
That's right. Yep. Pretty much.
Well, John, if someone else wants to send us an email, how would they do that?
They could do that, Kat, by typing into their computadoral machine. That's not a word. It's I kind of use Spanish, but then also not. Into their computer machine, they could type in my mistake podcast at. You know that little at with the A with a circle around it?
Oh, is that
what
that is?
That's the one. Mm-hmm. Okay. @gmail.com.
Okay, that's very helpful information.
Yep. Hey, question for you real quick while we're talking about that.
Doki.
What do you call the little tic-tac-toe symbol? What do you call that, Kat?
I would say that's the pound sign or the hash.
Okay. So not hashtag, but hash.
Hash.
Hash, pound sign. Mm-hmm. Okay.
What do you call it, John?
I also... Being from an era where phones were dialed every time.
And connected to a wall.
Pound sign was kind of the thing. And now it'll be like, hash mark. But mostly, pound sign would be what it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, unless I'm actually describing it in the context of a hashtag. But it's one of these things.
Sure. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I feel like there's a third major thing that people call it, and I can't remember what it is right now. Because I don't think it's tic-tac-toe symbol.
I mean, it looks like it.
It does. Because that one is so not popular, I figured I could use that to get the popular one that you use out.
I see.
Mm-hmm. You know, I wonder if they call that something different in, say, Tasmania.
Oh, or maybe the UK.
Or maybe the UK. Yeah. Or maybe in Sydney. Mm-hmm. Or maybe, I feel like we should ask somebody about that at some point. I mean, probably not right now, but
why not?
Soon. Yeah. Oh, okay.
I mean, should we?
Perhaps.
We can try.
We could try. It's, it's not too late in the game.
No. Okay. So what you need to do, John, is why don't you just go ahead and send them our friends, the Aussies, send them that link.
Okay.
And you'll see what we can do here.
Okay. All right. Here we go.
Okay.
It's people probably think that we actually planned it and we're pretending like we're just hitting the bump out of nowhere, but no. Through the magic of editing, we're like, This show's running a little short. Let's see if we can scare up some content.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is we're going to wait to see if they respond.
Mm-hmm.
And, or my dream is that they just pop in.
Right. That you would know? Be
like that
amazing.
Is my dream.
But like that, I want them to not, because I want them to have enough of a life going on that it doesn't take them like 30 seconds from the time they receive with no prompting whatsoever, just a Zoom link.
It's the my mistake bat signal, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They know that they're needed. Somewhere mm-hmm. content is needed.
Yep, and they, as Australians, have sworn to, they are available to provide it. Yeah. If someone needs content, find an Australian. They are oath bound.
They have to.
To provide
people content. Don't know that. They don't talk about that. Okay, we have an oi.
Oi. Oi. Oi.
All right. That's what that means. Perfect. Okay.
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Oi.
Give
oi,
us a few
oi.
Minutes. Okay, great. Okay, give us
fine.
A few minutes.
See, this is good. I want.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
Perfect. That's it. No other words need be spoken.
Nope, not at all.
Just means we have to vamp. Don't do your vampire impersonation.
Oh, you got it. You actually corrected me before I even realized I was about to do it, and I was about to do it, so it was happening.
All right, just do it then.
No, it's now that the spontaneity is gone. You ruined it.
I'm sorry. Right. The spontaneity. Mm-hmm. You do it every time. Does that
right,
count
it's spontaneous,
as being spontaneous
every single time.
All right. let's see. We got to talk about something.
Yeah, we do. Oh, we do. What's something are we going to talk about?
I don't know. So we have your question ready. You're going to ask them about the pound sign. How are you going to describe it? Is it going to be the?
I think I'll do
tic-tac-toe.
Tic-tac-toe. Okay. Yeah.
That's good.
Oh, and also then also what do you call a tie game? I imagine that it's going to be the same, but who knows? Like, what do you call a tie game of tic-tac-toe?
Oh, it's good question. It's
really
I can't think of it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a cat's game?
It's a cat's game.
Why mm-hmm. is it called that?
I don't know. I don't know. I could look that up.
Let's
if you wanna,
look that up.
If you want to vamp while I...
Oh, I want to suck your blood.
yes. Not only... Did it happen? I turned it around and made you do it.
Yeah. A cat's game. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm curious to know what that means. But and I'm guessing tic-tac-toe is a universal game. I feel like you go anywhere in the world, you make that sign, the pound sign, whatever, and you draw an X or an O somewhere on there. So there people are jumping in.
Yeah. I mean, here's the way I understand things like this. It might even be different symbols that they use, but it still would be the same. Like this is just emergent in a civilization that this game would exist. I really did not expect the explanation of why a tie game is called a cat's game in tic-tac-toe to be this interesting.
Lay it on me.
It comes from the concept that a cat cannot catch its own tail. Just like a player in tic-tac-toe cannot win a game that is already tied.
Huh.
I don't think that... The last part made me not like it as much. A cat cannot catch its own tail, meaning most games of tic-tac-toe end in a cat's game, right? Mm. Because it's a very simple game. The rules are very simple.
Yes.
So somebody has to kind of not be paying attention.
That's very true.
In order to lose at tic-tac-toe.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. But so yeah, it's interesting. A cat cannot catch its own tail. Well, that's one.
I mean, a cat can catch its own tail, though. That is the thing.
What
it chooses
true.
To do with its tail, that's another.
Once it catches it, that's a whole other thing.
Yeah, it's another story. Yeah. It's another ball of wax.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Are there more explanations or more?
I'm looking here. Okay. And this is cold reading. Back in grade school, whenever we played a game of tic-tac-toe, X's and O's, and the result was a tie, we would call it a cat's game. I've never heard this term applied to a tie in any other circumstance and was interested in where this term came from and why it seems to be unique to tic-tac-toe. Okay. I always thought it was because losing boards tended to have a C shape in the X's and O's.
No.
Oh, we have somebody knocking on the door here, Kat.
Knock, knock, knock.
Vegemite, Lamington, Pavlova, Tim Tam, Hugh Jackman. Outback, not the steakhouse. Kangaroos, didgeridoos, Barbies, boomerangs, Aussie slang, utes. Or cats, Arvo? Let's ask an Aussie. Let's ask an Aussie. We'll ask an Aussie. It's time to ask an Aussie. They'll know.
Hello! We have one Aussie. Two Aussies. Now I'm vamping and introducing at the same time. You cannot beat this.
Hi, you guys.
How's it going?
Hi, beautiful people.
Hello, beautiful people.
They've just got like tiny on the screen here. Let's fix that.
It's your computer.
Well, while you figure that out, thank you for answering the call.
Yes, thank you. You're never under any obligation, but we always love it when you do.
Well, you know, we weren't going to...
We just finished dinner. Perfect. That's why it was like a few minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a reason to pour a drink.
Ah, perfect. Very good.
We're gonna share this one tonight.
Very good.
Oh, yeah?
Let's have a little toast.
What's your adult beverage of choice there?
Thank you to the Aussies for coming.
It's
Angry Orchard.
Angry Orchard.
Ah, sure.
Cider.
Yeah.
Good, good.
Yes.
Mine is...
How are you both?
What's that?
Cheers, Big Ears.
Cheers, Big Ears.
Uncle Tito with Uncle Tito. Mango bubbly.
Yes.
Oh,
mango bubbly. Nice. Very nice.
I've got a beer. Yep.
A beer.
A beer.
Yeah.
So you mean Foster's? Because remember, they're Australian, we want to say.
No, 4X.
No, they. I know better than that.
Right. We've already established the non-truth that Foster's is Australian for beer. It is not.
And what are the Golden Girls having?
Oh, well.
Amazing. Where did you get that?
Cheesecake. It was actually a gift from a friend and co-host of my other podcast that we don't talk about here.
We never mentioned the She Nerds Out podcast on this podcast.
Okay. I don't know what you're talking about.
It was a gift from my friend Tara, who works in a hospital, awesome. By the way.
They are the greatest.
They are.
Where does one find cardboard cutouts of all four Golden Girls? Question.
I don't know. When it arrived, she was shocked at how big it was.
It's like life size, maybe bigger than life size.
It is bigger than life size because Sophia, who's the mother, the young, the old frail woman, is way too tall for real life. So yeah,
I think so.
It's larger than life.
Isn't it, in fact, the case that Sophia was the youngest actress of the cast, even though she played the oldest?
Even though she was
young. Del Getty was the youngest of all of them, yeah.
Yep. Crazy.
Crazy.
Amazing. And, I mean, listen, we could talk about Golden Girls trivia all fucking night, guys.
Is there anything specific to the Australian? Is there an Australian version of the Golden Girls?
There is not, but it played. We had very limited TV growing up.
Uh-huh.
Well, we didn't have cable.
We didn't have cable and stuff like that. We had like channels. Maybe four or five stations.
Well, I'm old, so I had that also.
Yeah. Right. So yeah. So, but every afternoon or every evening, they had the Girls.
Nice. Oh, so everybody watched it because
We love the Golden Girls. Mm-hmm. They're the greatest.
What's not to love?
Classic.
Exactly.
But no, we don't have an Australian equivalent as far as I know.
No. There's so many shows now that are being made in the United States based on UK shows.
Yeah.
All the time. Yep. Yeah. And they're never as good. Nope.
No, I know. I know for any Americans out there that have seen Kath and Kim.
Mm-hmm.
An Australian comedy show. It tried, the Americans bought it and tried to do an American version with Molly Shannon and I'm trying to remember who the other actress was. I could look it up, but it didn't, one season, bomb.
Yeah.
It just didn't translate. The Australian humor is so particular and so, that it worked. You can watch regular Kath and Kim on like Netflix.
Nice.
Very
okay.
Very Yeah. But yeah, it didn't quite cross over.
I feel like I have seen them. Is it kind of like an Absolutely Fabulous type thing or no? Very different.
Yeah. Kind of, but a little.
But redneck.
Not really redneck, like kind of bogan. Bogan. It's just bogan. Like we've gone through bogan, bogan means.
We've talked about bogan.
I think we've addressed the bogan in the room.
Redneck with less angst.
Right.
Okay. Less guns.
Yeah. Less guns. Yeah. Correct. No, it's redneck without guns.
No bunker.
I could live with those.
Yes.
Yeah.
They sound more than great.
They're kind of fun.
They sound lovely.
Yep. So, all right. I had come up with like basically an excuse to have you back on. I wanted to ask a question that then grew into maybe some more questions. I'm not sure. I assume that you are familiar with the game tic-tac-toe.
Yes. Okay.
Which we call it something
different. Oh, call it?
Did you call it X's and O's?
No.
Noughts and crosses.
Noughts and crosses.
Dots and crosses. Okay, see.
No, noughts.
Oh, noughts. So zero. Yeah. Okay.
Noughts.
Yeah, noughts and crosses.
Noughts and crosses.
See, already.
No, not noughts. No, noughts.
N-A-U-G-H-T-S.
Noughts.
Yes, but pronounce it correctly. Noughts.
Noughts. Noughts.
There we go. Noughts.
Noughts.
It's like noise.
Noughts.
Noughts. Noughts and crosses.
No, sorry, continue, John. Yeah. I
no, you haven't ruined anything. This is fantastic content. Thank you.
This is already better than what we were planning.
Totally. You've brought so much energy to the room.
Surely not.
Not.
Not. All right. Is there a particular... Okay, so first let me ask. The symbol, like say on your typewriter keyboard, that looks like a tic-tac-toe board, what do you use to refer to that as?
I've been coding for too long that I know what it would be called. So I'll let Liv.
Sorry, explain it again. Okay. So on your keyboard.
Right.
On the keyboard.
Right.
Yeah.
Number three.
Shift three. What do you call it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. What do I refer to that as?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, hashtag. Okay. No, I know that is. Yeah, but I also know it from way back American kind of. A la TV shows, probably like the Golden Girls, that was once called the pound key.
Yes.
Was
it pound key or pound sign? Key. Uh-huh.
When you're on the telephone, old school rotary.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. And the reason for that was it actually was a symbol for the measure of weight, the pound, at one time. So that's why, that's why it was called that. Yeah. All right. So you've been coding for a long time. Kitch, what do you call it?
The pound key.
The pound key. It's just that was just a question. I'm like, all right, this seems like we already have like two or three different things that it's called here just in the US.
So what other things do you call it? It's just like pound
number hash, sign.
Number sign.
Pound sign.
Yeah. The hash.
Hash or hashtag.
Yes, because if you're like apartment number one, I would put the hash. Pound and then number.
We've had to learn that since coming to America, though. That's not what's used to see. If you live in an apartment in Australia, that's not what you would find on
it. NO.1
envelope. No, it would be, well, there's a combination of things.
Unit.
You'd say unit.
Ah.
One.
Unit one.
Unit one.
Or,
it would always be unit.
Or flat. Flat or unit.
Yeah,
got it.
Really, but more units.
A lot of flat units in Australia.
Yeah. Gotta crawl in.
Well, okay, let's go back to tic-tac-toe.
Yeah, so back to tic-tac-toe.
Crosses and knots.
Knots and crosses.
No, knots and crosses.
Knots and crosses.
It rolls
off the tongue. let's say you're playing that game together, and... neither of you win. What do you call that? If neither of you are able to get three across, what do you call that?
It's a tie.
Right.
Okay.
Is that the only name you've heard for that?
Draw.
A draw. A draw. Tie.
Here's the thing. Australians have such fun and colorful names for everything.
We just assume.
Are we being boring?
It's so boring.
I'm sorry. Are we following the line too much here, are we?
we call it something else.
What do you call it?
John?
We call it a cat's game.
What?
Yeah.
Like as in cat crimmins?
I mean...
Yes.
People don't realize every game of tic-tac-toe that has ever been played that has ended in a draw has actually been won by Kat Krim.
By Kat.
Right here. No.
Never heard of Kat's game. That's
great. Where does that come from?
We didn't know. And then John just looked it up. John, right. Tell us again.
Okay. Or maybe we'll cut it from before when I said it and we'll just make this the...
That's a lot of work.
Whatever. All right. Our listeners know us. It's
sounds
fun.
Like work to me.
So the first one that I thought was pretty cool until I read into it, but it was saying that it's called a cat's game because a cat can't catch its own tail, which is... And so it's equally hard for someone to win a game of tic-tac-toe because it's such a simple game.
I don't know. I think a cat can catch its tail.
I have watched my cat catch her tail before, and it's not a measure of intelligence. I'm just going to tell you right now.
Fair enough.
It's just determination, sheer bloody-mindedness, if you will. And the other explanation was that games that end in a tie in tic-tac-toe usually have a C shape because you're kind of blocking people off, and it ends up being like an arch around the...
Okay, mm-hmm. Yeah. So there we go.
Not always, though. Sometimes it's a Z.
Sure. Or a Z, as you know, people call it in America.
America.
I like Z better, frankly.
I do too.
It's yeah. Z.
So yep. Better.
It's very final, X, Y, Z.
X, Y, Z, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like Z goes on.
I wish that the third letter of the alphabet was said, though, because you could say Abe said X, Y, Z.
There we go.
Because in American, it rhymes. A, B, C, X, Y, Z.
Yep.
Nice.
You're onto something.
Something. I don't know what. Probably nothing. So, yeah.
I was going to ask John to look something else up, because curious how long has tic-tac-toe or noughts and crosses been a game? Like, where does it come from? I mean, I don't know. Do you guys know?
No.
Oh.
I know there's another game that we call... there's a few games, actually, that get... So what you guys know as Clue, we call Cluedo.
Cluedo, yeah.
Okay. Like, that's right. Like the name on the box, or that's what you call
Cluedo.
It? Cluedo.
Yep.
But it's the exact same game.
Why do you think they changed the name? They didn't change it. They just added a couple letters.
Yeah. I have no Cluedo. Idea.
Okay. That's fun.
We played this last night. Oh,
Jenga.
Jenga.
Jenga. Love Jenga.
Another one. I can't remember what you guys call it. We call it snakes and ladders.
Oh, shoots and ladders is what we call it.
There you go.
Shoots and ladders.
Shoots and ladders.
So what's a shoot? Is that like a tree, like a branch shoot?
No, like C-H-U-T-E.
It's a slide.
Usually, like, we had coal shoots where, like, on the outside of the house there would be a bin and you would dump the coal into the bin and it would slide down the chute down into your heating plant. If you will.
There we go. Yep. Shoots and ladders. See, that's crazy.
Snakes and ladders.
Of course, there's snakes in there.
You slide down the snake and go up the ladder.
Because everybody I know slides down snakes.
Yeah, of course.
You know,
it is Australia. Like we're used to our reptiles.
Mm-hmm.
I love that game. Is it Candyland?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like snakes and ladders, but for kids, like less snakes.
Because it's all candy canes.
Less
right?
Snakes, like, more candy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Less snakes.
All right, I have a result, Kat. And this is via Weird History.
Love it.
At @weird_hist on Twitter. Mm-hmm. And they say, tic-tac-toe may be the oldest game in the world, being played in the Roman Empire over 2,100 years ago. And there is a photo of... what looks like a tic-tac-toe game or a noughts and crosses game carved in stone. Whoa. And here's the thing. I don't really buy that because who's got that kind of time to play noughts and crosses?
That would take a long time.
No, that would take way too long.
Agreed. Yeah. Agreed.
It would be a cat's game every time.
If you have enough time to think about your next move,
that's right.
It's really bad.
it's not good.
Mm-hmm. But I'm sending that photo along in any case.
Oh, very good.
I saw this awesome game when I was scanning through Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And it was it's like you get this like piece of string. Mm-hmm. You put it in a circle on a table. Mm-hmm. And then you got to place these stones, or maybe I think they're magnets. You got to place these magnets in, and then the next person places another magnet in, and then the next person, you just go back and forth.
They're black and white?
No, they're all the same color. But what happens is because you've got to place as many as possible inside the piece of string. Mm. And if you put them too close to another one of the magnets, mm-hmm. it zaps the magnets up. And if two magnets join, then you've got to take them out.
Oh.
And then I can put another magnet in.
Oh, at first I thought you were just describing Go, but then it's no, this is very different.
It's pretty cool.
How do you win?
So if you lose, if you get rid of all of your magnets, then you're the winner.
So you want to get rid of your magnets.
Mm-hmm. You want to place all of your magnets inside of the string.
But if you both get all your magnets in there, it's a cat's game.
I think you're making that up.
But that can't happen. Yeah, he's making that up because that can't happen. Someone has always placed, if it's a turn-based game, someone has always placed their last magnet before the other person.
Now you're just trying to make us feel good, Kitch.
That's what Kitch does.
He does.
That's what we do. We love you guys.
What was for dinner tonight? What do we have?
Oh, we tried something new tonight. Oh,
yeah?
Liv, do you want to?
It was, courtesy of Trader Joe's, or at least the carbohydrate part of it.
You guys know that I'm gluten-free, obviously.
Oh, I didn't
I'm one of those people. You know, how do you know if someone's gluten-free?
Don't worry. They'll let you know.
I'll tell you about it.
It was a cauliflower gnocchi.
Oh, okay.
Oh, and how'd that work out?
It was okay. Good.
I had a chicken bolognese.
Ooh.
And it was delicious.
Really good.
We had.
And yeah.
We had a bolognese. Michelle made a bolognese on Saturday night with bacon.
That's indulgent.
It was fantastic. It was actually mushroom and bacon, and it's one of the best things I've ever tasted.
So good.
And pappardelle. Did you make pappardelle pasta, or did you have that?
No, we didn't.
Oh, okay, fair.
Liv is so offended she left.
No. She's just. We've been talking about this for the last week.
No, because I was like, I literally said last night, I need to send these.
Need to send these.
Oh,
I hadn't thought about those at all in the intervening weeks.
For the listeners, on a recent trip to Australia,
mm-hmm.
when I say recent, 6 weeks ago, I got a packet of Tim Tams for Kat and a packet of Tim Tams for John. And if you choose to share them to your loved ones, that's totally up to you.
I think at this point I have to, because if I don't, then she's just going to think you never sent them.
No. What Tim Tams?
Mm-hmm.
I have seen Kat, and she is in possession of her Tim Tams. And I have not yet sent. But I will this week. I promise.
I would be willing to
drive. You know what I'm afraid of, though? I'm afraid they're going to get smashed
right.
in the post.
Right.
And they're going to come to you in crumbs.
You know,
and that's.
I feel like me driving for 20 minutes, 30 minutes.
That's not.
Oh, no, I think it is.
I know.
Those Tim Tams have made it across.
Hang on, you're going out.
I've just had a rescheduling, and it's not for a month, mm-hmm. but I'll be. Wait, these are good till August.
Oh, you're fine.
Sorry. I love it. So I'd eat them after August, I'll be honest with you.
I would too. You told me that. I was like, Liv, I don't care.
I will tell you the truth.
5 days are just a suggestion.
One of the questions that I had considered asking an Aussie, but I decided I was not going to do is, where are my fucking Tim Tams?
I love it.
Well, they're right ahead of you.
They're right here. Yeah.
Or I could eat them for dessert.
You could do that.
You eat them in front of us.
Oh, wow.
But I won't.
That would just be cruel.
That would be funny. It's funny because my Tim Tams
Thank you,
are,
Liv.
They're here. I haven't.
The fact that they are unopened after 6 weeks is telling you that's the devotion.
I feel important. I do.
That's love. Yeah. That's love right there. So, and the flavor, though, I've not seen this flavor ever before.
I know.
Salted caramel.
Especially made, I requested it just for John and Michelle.
Salted caramel brownie.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds amazing.
I could only fit one packet in each.
That's fine.
And they've extra chalk and extra gooey center.
And I ended up going for the one. I know the other one you requested was dark chocolate.
Right.
It was like those two. But given the reaction from Michelle after saying about the salted caramel brownie, that was got a more visceral reaction. So I went with that.
I think that's fair. Yeah, because it was we had asked for salted caramel and dark chocolate if you could fit two, but we fully understood that's asking a lot. But yeah, then you said, do you just want salted caramel or do you want salted caramel brownie? Yeah, that was the very authentic, very instant reaction.
So Liv bought so much back, but a lot of it didn't actually make it here.
Oh, no.
Is that right? Did you have a layover in the airport?
Yeah, no. So at the airport, the obviously the restrictions for how big a container can be with stuff in it before it gets confiscated.
Yeah.
Liv got how many things of...
3 jars of Vegemite taken away from me because this is the thing, caveat, I traveled to Australia with carry-on only. So I didn't have that in mind because usually I go in with check-in luggage and you shove as long as there's, no AK-47 or whatever in there, you can shove whatever in there.
You just fill it full of Vegemite, like fill the bag.
I've heard you could just stick a fuse into the Vegemite jar and if you lit it, it would act as an explosive device.
Probably. And this is the situation. So I just started the day before I left Australia, I went to the supermarket and got all the supplies, Tim Tams, various things, Vegemite. And I got the supplies not thinking that I had carry-on only.
Right.
And so I just packed it all in, hoped for the best. And the buggers, our trippers at the airport were like, nope, and took it away. And if you take a Vegemite away from an Australian, there is – it's not going to be pretty.
It's not good.
If you take a Vegemite away from an American, they will thank you.
So luckily, so the Tim Tams were left unscathed,
right.
But they took Vegemite.
There's some border control people. They're just like sitting at home with like a piece of toast with like Vegemite like heaped thick.
Right.
And just like laughing.
Got this to the airport.
I feel bad about making it away from to make them feel bad about taking it away from me, I requested that they send it to a homeless shelter.
Why would you do that? Why would you do that to homeless people? That's not nice.
No, all right, come now. Come on now.
Australian homeless love it.
True, I was like, sorry, if you're going to – I don't want these to just be thrown in the trash. Please, can you send these? Oh, we'll see. They're going to go.
They took it home.
Of course they did. Yeah.
That's the Australian TSA's reward at the end of the day. They get to take home all the knives and the Vegemite.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And power banks that are over a certain power rating.
And what?
Like power banks, those really expensive things to charge your phone.
Yeah,
sure,
If they're over a certain power rating, they'll take them.
I want to be mad about it, but I'm like, I get that because if they are over a certain power rating, you probably could rig an explosive device out of them. Yeah. Yeah. What are you going to do? You could do the same thing with a laptop battery, though. So I don't really mean to be giving advice to future terrorists here, but.
I got to say, though, every time I travel with my guitar, I always seem to end up getting the third degree from them. They look at me and they're like, "Oh, a musician. He's got to be dodgy.
The only way he's making any money is if he's smuggling drugs."
Exactly. But they'll open my case before they even lift the lid. They'll like look over at me. Then they'll lift the lid and look at the guitar, and then they'll look over at me again. And then they'll wipe the screens and look over at me, and I'm just like, "Come on!"
Now, do you have a hard shell case or soft case?
I actually, our last trip back to Australia together, I ended up getting a travel guitar, a Taylor Mini, GS Mini guitar, and it's perfect size because they will let you take it on the plane and it fits in the overhead baggage.
Oh, nice.
That's nice.
It's a fantastic guitar. It's not the best guitar in the world, But for traveling, it's like perfect, and it's just like.
And in true Kitsch style, he didn't answer your question.
So I'm
you.
A politician. What was the question?
Hard case.
If I'm touring,
yeah. hard case. Always. Yeah.
I've had guitars, guitar cases that have been like buckled in from the airport and have just missed my guitar smashing.
Wow.
And I've had friends who've had guitars like completely ruined.
You've seen that there's like various, you know, I don't know, I guess I'm sure Reddit threads.
Reddit threads.
Where it's like United destroyed my guitar or, you know, whatever airline, Southwest. And there's people have actually taken, you know, they've taken footage or a photo of from the tarmac.
Right.
From the
plane. On the plane into the other window. Like,
watching it being destroyed. Ugh.
Yeah.
Like launching into the air.
Your heart would just be in your throat.
You know, there used to be an ad. Oops, sorry. What cat?
Nope.
There used to be an advertisement on TV.
Sorry.
No worries.
Dad's calling.
Sorry about that.
No worries.
Unbelievable. Unprofessional, frankly.
I can't believe after we booked you months in advance for this gig, you didn't mute your phone?
I can't believe it.
Do you need to take the call seriously? That's
no, I don't. It's all good. It's just my dad calling to say hi.
You should answer.
I'll write back. Fine. No, dad's
he calls all the time.
Okay, well, that's
all the time.
Where was I going? Shiza. I don't remember.
Luggage.
Oh, luggage. There was a television ad in the 70s in the United States for Samsonite luggage. And it was just a chimpanzee that was like, you'd see the suitcase go behind the, you know, the hanging things into the room that you never can see. And in there was just a chimpanzee who would pick up the bags and throw them at the wall and just jump up and down on them. And all that. And only the Samsonite bags were the ones that survived and stayed good.
That's
so
pretty accurate, though. I think that's how they treat all your shit.
For sure.
They don't give a fuck.
Exactly.
Now, listen, I want to talk about Vegemite. So we have a listener, Beck. She lives in Tasmania.
Right.
You guys call it Tazzy or something? What's your cute name?
Tazzy.
Daddy.
He was actually just texting with a friend who lives in Tasmania last night.
We love Beck. Beck, do you know Beck?
So
probably.
Beck,
hi, Beck.
Beck, Hannah Gadsby, and your friend. And that's, you know, most of
them. That's the population of Tasmania.
So, you know, last time I think we had you guys on, Liv, you were about to go over on your trip.
Yes.
And we were talking about Vegemite, giving Vegemite a hard time. And, Beck says, this is an email that she'd sent. This is back in January. So that timing seems about right, right? January 20, it doesn't matter.
Ish,
Beck says, everyone outside of Australia is so quick to say how gross Vegemite is. It's not gross. You aren't doing it right. You don't put it on thick. I've seen many a non-Australian spread their toast with way too much Vegemite. It's a salty spread. You only need a small amount. Lots of butter. A little bit of Vegemite, right. Keep that disrespect in check. Is that how you also prepare your toast?
Absolutely.
Okay. Correct.
Yeah,
is on it.
I find that things that are really good, I like to have as little of them as possible. That's the best way to have things that are delicious.
So these Tim Tams will come your way with one.
So what I think what needs to happen is that we need to all get together, we need to record an episode, and I would love it if you could prepare John and I with some Vegemite toast.
Absolutely fantastic.
Okay.
The right way.
And
have you not tried it before, either of you?
I have.
No.
I feel like I've tried it, but we should try again.
I've tried it, but I feel like I did it thick. So we'll see if that's the case.
You don't eat it like Nutella. Yep.
No. Yep. Peanut butter or any of other.
Yeah. Beck had also recommended Shapes, but it was too late. You had already left before.
Are Shapes good?
As in,
like a cracker. Yeah. They're a cracker.
Pizza Shapes, like at university.
Mm-hmm.
I was a little bit addicted to Pizza Shapes. No, so barbecue shapes.
Okay.
Yeah, pizza is the superior flavor, followed by barbecue and then nacho cheese. Does that sound right? Oh, you like barbecue best.
Yeah, barbecue is definitely the best.
Okay. Well, we've got an Aussie fight here.
Controversy, I like it.
I think that they lace it with like cocaine or something because that
that makes sense. She also recommended we get some Milo. Do you guys like?
Oh yeah,
you like the Milo.
Okay.
Have you not tried Milo?
I don't know. Is it like chocolate milk kind of?
Yeah.
It's like a coarser,
crunchier
oval Nesquik.
Okay. Ovaltine Nesquik.
In a can that you put in with milk and stir it around, but it's more of it's crunchy rather than granularly, rather than a powder.
Okay.
Milo is one of my favorite things in the whole world.
Oh yeah,
I can't have it anymore because of gluten thing.
Right.
But the thing is, like, I liked Milo so much that I wanted to get a guitar that was the color of the Milo tin. That when I flipped it over, remember what's Bad Medicine? The video clip of Bad Medicine. Where Bon Jovi like flips over his guitar and it says "Bad Medicine" on the back, and I wanted to have Milo. A guitar and I flipped over and just said Milo. That was how much I liked Milo.
Wow, that's a lot.
Beck advised us that the one thing about Milo she didn't agree with was the instructions on how much to put in.
Correct.
There's no instructions.
No, she said that what they advised was not nearly as much as you should actually put in.
Correct.
Oh yeah. No, it's people like to say, would you like to have some milk with your Milo?
I love it.
I gotta try some Milo.
Yeah. There's
best.
If you were to just there's even the guide on the internet, if you were to Google Milo teaspoon. Mm-hmm. See it says level teaspoon.
Heaped teaspoon.
Heaped teaspoon and Milo.
And Milo teaspoon. That's amazing. So a mountain on a tin. Yes.
Yep. All right. There's much. Yeah.
I feel like in the spirit of reciprocity, I need to figure out some foods that you have not had, and we might need to have an international exchange of culinary delights. But I'm not.
Sure, and maybe we can do foods that are along those, like the same, so similar lines. So if the shapes, a yummy cracker. So is there like an equivalent? So we can do like a taste comparison.
Cheez-Its? Have you had Cheez-Its?
Little Bugles.
Yeah, I have had a Cheez-It.
Okay.
It's not quite the same.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it would Wheat Thins, no. I'm not going to defend Wheat Thins.
But maybe not. We can do something.
We'll figure it out.
Anything random. Anything that's, because there's a lot of stuff that's very, like, I've never had a Tootsie Roll.
Mm. Oh, my goodness.
Stuff that are very quintessentially American, at least that we grow up with watching American TV and films and we hear about, and I've never tried, because that's because apparently it's just packed full of sugar.
It
is
packed full of sugar. I would need to look to see if it has gelatin in it before I would recommend that you have one, though. If you are that strict with your vegetarianism, I'm not sure.
But you haven't had taffy?
I would try it. I haven't had, there's a lot that taffy. I haven't had.
Laffy taffy, that's the stuff. I mean, honestly, saltwater taffy is, but you can't get that outside of, like, the East Coast.
That's not true.
Wait, you can get saltwater taffy here in California?
Absolutely. I have a bag of it in my cupboard.
It's
from Morro Bay, brother. It's on the ocean.
I bet it's not as good.
Come on over and try it, dude.
Is it actually salty? Tastes salty?
Not really.
Can they say?
No. I mean, maybe
I don't
a
know
bit.
Why it's saltwater taffy.
It's not like super sweet. It's like the flavors are pretty subtle, but it's an enjoyable experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, we might need it. Yeah, we're going to... We need to compile a potluck.
Yeah, it's all gonna be crap. It's all just
from across the Well, and like there is no equivalent to Nutella. Nutella is the best thing ever.
It is the greatest thing that's ever been invented.
Nutella's great.
Yeah.
Yes.
And neither the United States, United States nor Australia can claim
Belgium.
We can't claim that one.
No. I'm pretty sure it's like Belgium or something. People of Belgium.
That's what I just said. Then it's fine.
Oh, you did say that? I hear you.
It's okay.
Yeah, sometimes I don't listen to Kat.
I stay very quiet because I know I'm, you know, nobody wants to hear what Kat's saying, but I'll just say it down here. It's Belgium. It's from Belgium.
Amazing.
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 Well, thank you.
I love the trim beard, by the way.
I know. Is that you're just getting ready for summer?
No, I did it in January, which doesn't make any sense to trim your beard. And this is honestly about probably 5 weeks of untrimmed. I trimmed it for 2 months or so, and now it's growing back out. I like to get out of the Santa phase right after Christmas.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm. But I'm coming back into it.
Yeah, it looks good.
Looking good.
Looks good.
Yeah.
Yep.
Kitch, can you grow a beard?
What's that?
Can you grow a beard? Have you?
I shaved this morning. So.
Oh yes, then he can because.
When I was playing the.
Oh, that's
the
right. Of course.
They would give me 10 days notice for a gig, and I'd grow in the 10 days. I'd grow a goatee.
That's right. I've seen your goatee.
Very hairy guy. Like as soon as I let it go.
Is there a name for the stubble that people grow?
5 o'clock shadow.
Okay, same thing here. Yeah. I was just trying. What's it going to be? It's going to. Yeah, I couldn't even think of anything. A chinny shadow.
You've got an octopus on your chin, mate.
I'm awful. Anyway, since you've provided so much content, would you like to, you know, help us sign off?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Is it things are good at the moment, like, you know, with what's going on. But you know, in that same vein, it's good to say these words.
Sure.
Always.
People have questioned whether we should continue to do this for one reason or another, and I have been unwavering in my commitment to doing what we do to Mike Pence.
We do not mind. We do not mind joining in.
Okay, wonderful, wonderful. If you want to lead, we will join in with you.
Can I start the first syllable and then everyone join in?
I love it.
We can try.
1, 2, 3.
Fuck
Mike Pence. These things don't work well over Zoom, but what are you going to do?
It was perfect.
Awesome.
Thank you, guys.
I support your commitment, John. Just to, I know that was supposed to be the end.
That's fine.
It is.
Not, just because he seems to, from week to week, do something to justify said sign-off.
Yeah. Anytime you start to get a feeling like maybe this guy's not so bad, no, don't worry. No, just wait.
Wait.
No. It's like the weather, you know.
In Hawaii.
So I fully support you. So FMP.
FMP.
FMP.